Vindictus 2022 High Saviors, GH here. Today we're gonna do a Vindictus gameplay from the beginning to show you guys what it's like playing the game from the start. Vindictus is an instance-based action fantasy MMORPG, and with that said, let's do this! Let's go play the game, okay guys? I think these are the characters, and here's the land. Here's Fiona, here's Evie, Karok, Kai, Vela, Herc, Lynn, Arisha, Silas, Delia, Miri, Grimden, Ira, Bell, Lethor, Kale, Tessa, and Donna. Okay, so what are we gonna pick? We're gonna play as Lethor. I think he's a knuckle fighter, so we're gonna pick this one. Start with this character. And here goes the character customization, guys. And in here, we can change the hairstyle. Look at this. But there's only a few hairstyles over here. Let's pick this one. We can also change the skin color and body type. Of course, there's a lot of sliders over here. You can change the waist, body fat, chest. Of course, it's already maxed out. Okay, height, arms. Okay, but wait a minute. I think their character customization is not that in-depth. It's okay. It's enough. But okay, let's create this character. I think that's it. Most of the other things here on the left side are just preview of the expression, the pose, and there's a glow. Okay, how about the outfits? Let's test one outfit. Here's one. Here's the number two outfit. Here's the number three outfit. And here's the number four outfit. Let's create this character. Okay, let's name our character. Create? Yes. Oh, what's this? It's a story. I thought it's a loading screen. Skip everything. Man, there's a lot of dialogues. This is their attempt on the story. And there it goes. Start prologue. And there it goes. Another cutscene. Get it together, rookie. Can we skip this? Trying to skip it. Okay, we're in the game. Battle controls, normal attack. Okay, there it goes. What happened? I can't hear the sound effects. Okay, let's fight these enemies first. Ooh, I'm liking the combat. But, what's happening here? I can lift up the enemy. Look at this. Can I throw them? Oh no, I can use them to smash enemies. Can I throw them? Oh yeah, I can throw them. I kinda wanna enable the sound effects because it's not satisfying not hearing the punches. Okay, anyway, let's proceed. I'm gonna enable it after this prologue. Battle controls. Battle controls, change view. I can run with shift. Let's go. Where are we going? Spacebar is the dodge. Alt is to summon the cursor. Okay, here's the cursor. What are we supposed to do next? Okay, we need to climb here. Let's proceed. More enemies. Dodge defense. Okay, we're dodging. Is that it? Let's go. I feel like I'm just going in circles. Because the corridors looks the same. Okay, let's go over there. There's a symbol. Let's go! Yeah, I really need to enable the sound effects. Why is it disabled by default? Why did they do that? Anyway, let's go! What's this girl supposed to do? A girl is following me. Okay, whatever. I think this will collapse. It looks like it will collapse. Oh yeah, it is collapsing. Oh no, the roof collapsed. Okay, I need to carry her. Let's go! Now what? I need to jump? Oh no. Go here. Can we run? No, we can't run. And there goes the first boss. It's a spider. And what's happening here? The spider is the girl's pet? Okay. Can we skip this? No. The whole prologue is gonna skip if I skip this cutscene. So I gotta have to watch it. And what's happening here? Of course, we're gonna fight the spider. Active skills. That's my first active skill. Here's the second one. No, I only have one active skill. Ooh, I dodged that. Let's go! A boss fighting in this game will be fun. Let's go! But the cooldown of my skill takes too long! Let's go! Dodge. Dodge to the side. Hit him from behind. And the camera, what's happening? Why is it first person? Man, the camera, what? Oh, man. Dodge. Active skill. Dodge. Am I immune to damage when I'm dodging? I don't have any HP, so I guess I'm invincible. Did we defeat him? No, not yet. Man, the camera in this game. Look at this. It has its own mind. What's happening here? We're focused on the spider. I can't really fight it because it's climbing. What am I supposed to do? It looks awesome though. Come down here, bruh. What am I supposed to do? Oh, and he's falling down. London Bridges. Let's go! Oh, I can punch him. Oh, the bell. Oh, boom. Of course, the spider is dead. The bell fell down on him. Now what? Should I finish him off? Nope. I think that's the prologue. And cutscene. Of course, the girl is gonna try to save him after he attacked us. And the prologue is over. More dialogues. Skip everything. Go to town. There's our select hero, which is nice. I guess if you don't want the hero that you chose. Man, we're at the town, but the game is glitching. And now, it's okay now. And we're at the first town. It's doing this, some kind of presenting the town. Okay, anyway, can we move? There it goes, we can move. Our first quest is find Marek at the mercenary outpost. And thankfully, there's a guide. But first, let's check out the doggos. Look at this. There are doggos in-game. And there are other players over here. Look at them. Okay. And there's a small character over here. Is that a pet? Here's another player. She's thick. Here's another one. And okay, there's a dude. I thought everyone here is a female. Okay. Let's follow the guide. There's somebody playing over here. He's level one also. Let's go at the mercenary outpost. Oh, this is how we talk to an NPC. There goes Marek. F1. Marek and Gwyn are too busy arguing to notice you. Okay. So how about Ciara? Man, I gotta say, I don't like this conversation thing that they have here. Okay, anyway, our next quest is complete the battle quest. Mercenary training site and return to the mercenary outpost. Okay, how do we get out of here? Exit. Let's follow the guide. It's nice to know there are people playing. Why are they in robes? I thought this one has a skin. Oh, I think it's not loaded yet. Let's wait for the skin to load. And there it goes. She's a fairy. Let's go. Look at this. He's got a pet. A wolf. Okay. The actual town itself. To be honest, it doesn't look that great. But the character models looks awesome. Look at this. Look at this character. It looks awesome. It's very detailed. Look at this one. Okay. What are we supposed to do? Interact with this thing? Okay, let's go to this Perilous Ruins mercenary training site. Click it. I'm clicking it, bro. Depart solo. Depart. Oh, okay. So Vindictus is instance based. We're in the hub town at the moment. Now we're going to this instance dungeon. Okay. I thought Vindictus is a traditional MMORPG, but no. I guess this is fine. This is more action packed. Ooh, what's this? Man, there's a conversation happening below. It's just, I don't want to focus on it. I want to play, but I think it's forcing me to read it. No, bruh, no. No, bruh. And there goes the first enemies. Let go. Attack them. I forgot I need to enable the sound effects. Yep. Time out. I'm gonna enable the sound effects. Man, how can I fiddle with the settings here? Okay, I can't find the settings. I'm pressing escape, but it only summons my cursor. How about this? Is this the settings? Nope. I think I need to log out because I kinda saw an options on the login screen. Okay, anyway. I'm gonna log out after this instance dungeon. Let's go. Attack this dummy. Combat tip. Potions. Heavy attack. Boom. If there's a global server for Vindictus, I would have included this on my top instance dungeon because I'm liking the combat. You know, character models looks great. And so far, it's looking pretty good. Okay, anyway, what are we supposed to do now? More basic enemies. Let's go. Why are they telling me to carry this one? Throw him. Let's proceed. But to be honest, guys, I'm not liking the map designs. Looks old school. Am I supposed to loot that thing over here? A loot? Oh, secondary weapon. Ah, I can use it to throw. Boom. Okay. Get another one. Throw it again. This is gonna take a while. Okay, let's go. Let's just do it manually. The fence is gone. Dodge. Now what? Combat tip. SP. Tutorial is still not done. Active skills. Okay, Z. Here's a shortcut for an active skill. But I don't see the cooldown. F is used to throw this. F is used to throw this ball. Then Z is a skill. I think this is the first boss. Oh yeah. Some kind of a... Is that a cat or a dog? Let's go. Wolf tail. Active skill. Dodge. Let's go. Dodge. Where's the cooldown for my dodge? I'm trying to dodge, but it's not happening. I think it's because there's a cooldown for the dodge. Ooh. And there it goes. We win. Battle cleared. Okay, guys. Usually, this is the part that I show you guys the cash shop, but I couldn't find it, which is good. Because usually MMORPGs makes it easier to find the cash shop. You can see a big, huge icon on the UI that says cash shop. But in this game, I can't find it. But as I am browsing, I found this exchange shop. I don't think this is the cash shop, but it kinda offers items that you would typically find in the cash shop, like this premium armor enhancement prune, which protects your armors and weapons from breaking if you use this item, and so as this enchant rune, it also protects your equipments from breaking, and items that gives additional stats. But it's not the cash shop. You can't really buy this. You need to play the game to be able to get all of this item. Look at this ticket shop. To get that ticket, you need to play the game. That ticket is a coupon earned from completing missions. So you gotta play the game to get this tickets. And even the seals. These seals are given by the Mercenary Cooperative Association to those who help others. So to be able to take advantage of this exchange shop, you gotta play the game. So this is not the cash shop. And I think this is the cash shop, the supply depot. But for some reason, there's an error. I can't open it. So, but don't worry. I kind of found a place where you can buy stuff. And this is it. The avatar shop. If you open this, the game will go into this. Okay, let's just open it. Outfitter shop. And there it goes, guys. We're in the outfitter shop. And in this shop, you can try out different skins. Look at this. Here's the first skin. And you can buy this in this outfitter shop. Look at this. Purchase. And there it goes. You can buy it. You can purchase with NX. And then complete your purchase. Let's check out the different skins that they're selling. The skins, by the way, doesn't have any stats. Or at least the description tells us that there's no stats. Okay, here's the second skin. Third skin. There's also versions of these skins that only offers parts like this one. How can I go to the default? Okay, anyway, here's another skin that you can buy. Here's another one. Let's preview all of them. All of them looks detailed. And what is this? Here's another one. Kimono. What? A jester set? So you can kind of look like Harley Quinn. Okay, and here's the last available skin for this character. Okay, there's also a dye shop over here. You can buy different colors. And an avatar shop. What's this avatar shop? Oh, okay, this is how your character look. You can change the hairstyle, skin, face, and inner. Okay. Ooh. Yup. You can change the inner part of your character and the body type. And you can have a different lens. All of it, you can buy it. And this is as close that I could get from a cash shop. This is actually the way you do it because this isn't pay to win. This is nice. Okay, let's close this. Leave. But this is a Korean MMORPG. There should be some kind of a cash shop over here. It's probably an NPC located in this hub town. It's just I'm not familiar with the town yet. Okay, anyway. But it's nice that you can't really buy stuff that easily except for the avatar stuff. Okay, anyway, let's proceed with the game. And by the way, guys, I couldn't enable the audio, I mean the sound effects, so that we can hear the punches like, are you okay? We can't hear that. I don't know why. Even the footstep, there's no footsteps in the game. I don't know what's happening here, or it's probably just me. I couldn't find the settings. I found the settings. Here's the settings, guys. Options. Audio. There's no sound effects volume. There's only game volume and music volume. I can't make you guys listen to the music volume because, you know, YouTube. And that's about it. Okay, anyway, let's play the game. Let's follow the guide. Let's go to the mercenary outpost. Who do we need to talk to? Ciara, okay. Skip paragraph. Let's go. And now what? It's covering my quest. My next quest is complete the battle quest for Morion Emblem and talk to Marek. We got a new gear. We're gonna wear it outside. Close this thing. Let's talk to Marek. Okay, don't forget to equip your secondary weapon. Okay, and let's go exit and do the next quest. Thankfully, there's a guide that we can follow. Look at this dog. It's coming close to us. That's nice. Okay, open the inventory. Let's wear this. Crimson Blade Tunic. Wait a minute. Let's look at our character. Of course, we're gonna change appearance. Let's equip this Crimson Blade Tunic. Close this, and there it goes. That's the tunic. The Marek dude told me that I need to equip a secondary weapon. I think this is it. Trainee spear or what? Man, I can only equip either this spear or this one. I can't really mention it because YouTube. Okay, let's follow the guide. Depart for battle. Story progression mode. What? I pressed that and it loaded. And we're in the instance dungeon. Oh yeah, that's the quest for Morion Emblem. Let's go proceed. There's spiders over here. Okay. Active skill. Oh no, I can't. So let's just basic attack. I really kind of want to hear the sound effects. Anyone knows over here what I'm missing? Please tell me in the comments. So next time I play this game, there's sound effects. Okay. More enemies. Let's go. Dodge. Heavy punch. Get that item. Got a life erg crystal. I don't really know where to go. I'm just following the laid out path. Overkill. Let's climb. Why is this dead spider still moving? Okay, let's climb. Man, it really bothers me. There's no audio. Oh, attack. What? I can't use the active skill. I think we should check out our skills. We may have something here. I just need to put it on my shortcut key. This worm. Oh, attack. I have a new title. Okay, we defeated them. Let's press K and see if we can open our skills. Nope. Oh, I can't set up now. I can only set up at the town. Okay, anyway, let's proceed. And there goes the first boss. Is that the first boss? Active skill! Oh, I missed. But I hit the minion though. Dodge. Heavy attack. Dodge. Heavy attack. Let's go. My skill is still on cooldown. Okay, let's try using the spear. Ooh, ah, it's a throwing item. Okay, let's go. Boom! Okay, I like the feeling. Holy, there's sound effects. I'm gonna compensate for the sound effect. Oh yeah, yeah. Erlukit. Man. I'm stuck. Use the spear. Wow, the spear is strong. Okay, let's go. Finish you off. Heavy attack. It's a backhand attack. And he's defeated. Okay, enough with the slow motion. The enemy's defeated. Let's go. Are we done? I think we're done. Completed that. Okay, return to town. Let's set up our skills. I want new skills. Okay, close this. And then check out our skills. How can we check out our skills? There goes the skills. Common skill. Pressed. Okay, there's a requirement. A level requirement. Man, this is a passive. I want another skill. Tiger Claw. Let's put it here. Okay, we got Tiger Claw. And that's the preview. I mean, Tiger Claw is the active skill that I was using. It's the one that I put on Zay. Why can't I put it on Zay? Come on. Okay, anyway, let's put it at 1. Yep. We need to be at least rank 18 to be able to use this cartwheel skill. Oh no, that's the dodge. What? Okay, anyway, let's do another quest. Look at this Sauron looking dude. He's taking care of his pigs. Very hardworking. Okay, let's go do the quest. What's happening here? It kind of opened my skill menu. What? Select one of your skills. and advance it to rank E. Okay, so I need to level up one of my skills. Let's open it again. Skills. This one? You want me to... Or this one? Oh yeah, he wants me to train my combat mastery. Is that it? Restoration? Oh, I can kinda get this cartwheel over here. Train? And there it goes, we got another skill. Ah, we can get this diamond. I wasn't looking at this side. That's why I didn't see it. But okay, now we got this one. We can put it, okay? Talk to Ciara. Let's go. I need to select one of my skills and advance it to rank E. Use AP. Is that it? Am I done? I've advanced it. Okay, I'm done. Okay, talk to Ciara again. Skip all that paragraph. Let's go play the game. Now I need to talk to Christy at the traveler shop. Ooh, is that the cash shop? Okay, let's leave and go to that traveler shop. So far in terms of performance, the game is running pretty well except when we just got out of an area. It would slightly stutter when loading assets, but after that, it's very stable. I think this is the traveler shop. What am I looking for? Okay, inspect necklace. Okay, he gave us a few stuff and this, a reward. Okay, press okay. Ah, okay, claim reward. Got a bed. Okay, close this. Now we need to return to mercenary unit and talk to Ciara. Okay, leave. Let's try equipping the stuff that we got. What's this? A new armor. Let's try equipping it. Okay, that's it. Equip the raiment pants and the veteran raiment helm. Equip. What? We're gonna look odd. Look at this. We're wearing a helmet. Okay, sure. And this belt. Equip. I can't equip it. Oh, I think I equipped it. It's just lagging. Okay, anyway, let's go to the outpost. Get another quest. I'm back. Let's go. Give me another quest. Okay, there it goes. A new battle quest. But first, we need to talk to Ciara. Exit. Let's do the battle quest. Ooh, look at this player. I think she's a samurai. What's the name of that character? Dan-ah. Anyway, let's depart. Story progression mode. And there it goes. We're in a dungeon. Let's proceed. Run. Combat tip. Ooh, traps. There goes a trap. Ooh, dodge. I almost got hit by that trap. Dodge. But how can I proceed? Oh, I need to go to the sides. Enemies. Oh, I need to put another skill. I forgot to put a skill. I have other skills. Forgot, man. Okay, anyway. Are those enemies? Those green things over there? Let's go. Yeah, they're enemies. I thought they're some kind of attacks. Get these things. The early monsters in these games are pretty dull. I guess as we progress in the game, we're gonna fight, you know, better looking enemies. So far we've been fighting spiders, some kind of dog humanoids. And there they go, let's go! Heavy attack. Active skill. An archer, huh? I'm gonna spear you. Let's go! Boom! Is there a lock-on in this game? I'm kinda looking for a lock-on. This one is really difficult to kill. Oh, he's the boss? Oh yeah, he's the boss! And he's defeated. And that's Vindictus from the start. I was expecting a traditional MMORPG, but turns out it's a hub MMORPG or instance-based MMORPG. Anyways, the questing is seamless. There's a guide. And you know, typical hub MMORPG is very simple. Now, the combat is action, which is very nice. I like how my chosen character attacks. It's just, for some reason, there's no sound effect. I don't know what happened there, but I'm pretty sure there's a fix here. I just couldn't find it. Now, the graphics is okay. The character models look nice and very detailed. But the maps and the environments, in my opinion, is getting very dated. As for the frame rates, when you're in combat and in the town, it's fine and stable. It will only stutter when you just arrive at a certain area, and it's only for a brief moment. All in all, Vindictus is a decent MMORPG, and if you guys want to check the game out, the details are on the screen. And if you like the video, hit the thumbs up. share, and then subscribe to be part of the Gaming Hardcore family. And as always, this is Gaming Hardcore. See you in the next one.